I'm at the National Association of EMS Educators Conference in Reno, Nevada, and at the exhibitor booth, and I'm at the SonoSim booth, revolutionary laptop-based ultrasound training. And SonoSim is partnering with Laerdal. Have I got that right?
Correct.
Okay, great. And I'm here with Dan. And Dan, maybe you can tell us a little bit about, now, are you going to tell me about doing ultrasound in the pre-hospital setting, or are you going to tell me about the educational piece?
I'll tell you about both.
Okay, so we're going to talk a little louder.
Sure. So we're seeing a big trend right now in EMS education.
Okay.
We're seeing that some hospital systems, pre-hospital systems, are integrating ultrasound into their training. Mm-hmm. For example, in Dallas, I know that the rigs over there have ultrasound machines on board.
So in Dallas, they've got the ultrasound. So what are they using ultrasound for? So give me some examples.
Right. So, for example, for assessing cardiac activity.
Okay. So
you might be feeling your pulse. Well, you may be feeling your pulse during a code, and the patient's heart's actually beating. So you're there, chomping on their chest, and they don't really need compressions. Right. Putting a probe on the heart real quick and show you if the heart is beating, and not necessarily wall motion abnormalities, but is that heart beating vigorously or is it not?
So you can tell whether it's beating vigorously or not, because when you get someone with a pulseless electrical activity and they've got a low cardiac output state, is there a way to distinguish between what's good motion that would say don't do CPR despite the fact that you can't palpate a pulse, or do we fall back on the basics that they're unresponsive, they're pulseless, we still do CPR?
Right, that's debatable, but you can tell obviously if there's some cardiac activity or not.
Yeah.
You can use ultrasound to assess whether or not you have a right main stem intubation. Is there lung sliding or not?
So that's helpful.
You can use it for pneumothorax assessment. Do you really need to take a catheter right now and shove it in the patient's chest?
Right.
So, airway assessment, pneumothorax assessment, cardiac assessment, you can use it to look at a baby, a woman who's got a gravid uterus and you want to just do a quick check of what's going on with the baby.
Right.
Baby's moving, is the baby's heart still beating okay?
If it's breech, I'm just turning the monitor off. I don't want to look anymore. I'm getting the heck out of there.
You're stepping it up from 60 to 120 miles an hour at that point.
Yeah, my heart rate's going to 160 miles an hour too. Yeah.
I mean, we can see a lot of applications. It becomes really interesting. Especially with aeromedical transport, where it's really loud and you can't rely on your stethoscope. So lots of applications for ultrasound. We know this from the military, and obviously we're seeing this translated now to civilian healthcare systems.
Right.
So what SonoSim has done is basically created a self-directed ultrasound training course. When you try to teach people how to do ultrasound, it's a complex process. It requires an instructor, it requires a student, it requires an ultrasound machine, and it requires a patient.
Yeah.
And then that patient hopefully has some pathology, because you want to show a positive FAT scan, not just the normal abdomen.
It's good to know the normal, though, just as a baseline.
It's good to know the normal, and then you got to show multiple iterations of normal and multiple iterations of abnormal.
Right.
So what we've done basically is created a self-directed course that allows you to get didactic content, the knowledge assessment, and then do hands-on training through simulation.
Yeah.
And in essence, we've managed to capture all of that in the course environment.
So you can maximize the learning before you get to the hands-on component.
Correct.
Through online learning. And this is computer-based here. Are you going to show this to me?
I can show it to you. It's all cloud-based, computer-based learning. I think you just mentioned something which was important, which is the flipped classroom environment and the asynchronous learning. So students basically would come onto our SonoSim course library over here. This is all cloud-based. It can be accessed off of an iPad at home, Starbucks, wherever it is that you're at. I mean, we even have somebody over here.
Most people study at Starbucks.
No. This is where most people study. This is the best way to learn ultrasound, by the pool.
I couldn't study there. There's drinks by the pool.
So, you know, we'll start with that. Let's go to one of the classic EMS applications, the FAST protocol.
Okay.
So again, this is a self-directed ultrasound course. It's evidence-based and peer-reviewed.
And ER docs do the FAST assessment. That's very common practice.
Absolutely. That's what they do when they...
Because I hear guys like Scott Weingart from EM Care
talking
about
FAST exam has
assessments.
Four major windows.
Yeah.
The first window of the...
So here, you take
we're looking at a half-naked guy. This is going to be an X-rated video now.
Towards the patient's head.
There's your probe, how to orient it, how to position it. And then once you position it in this area, what you're going to do is be looking at the liver and the kidney.
And the probe.
And you can see that it's all narrated.
In order to see,
here's your liver right over here. Here's your
kidney.
So we're basically, again, taking you through a session, teaching you about how to do this. But now, a really cool part of SonoSim is once you've got
all I saw was something gray and something looked like a butterfly.
Right. So it's hard to understand what ultrasound really is, isn't it?
Right.
I'm going to show you what it is. Really simple.
Okay, cool.
So ultrasound is a technology that basically relies on this probe having a beam come out of it.
Yeah.
And at the point where it intersects your underlying anatomy, you get an image, which is a two-dimensional image. I know none of that made sense just now, so let me just show you that with a very simple object.
So it bounces sound waves off the organ?
Off of the organ, correct.
Right.
Now, in this box, what we've done is this is a cognitive task trainer. We're going to scan through the box.
I love that term, cognitive task trainer.
You like that?
I'm going to use that in the classroom.
It's our skills box.
I'm not going to introduce myself as a teacher anymore. I'm going to say I'm the cognitive task trainer.
So,
or task master.
Here we go. The concept of ultrasound, for anybody who's never seen it before, I'm going to turn your camera just a little bit this way.
Okay.
So you capture that right there.
Oh,
well.
Okay.
Here we go.
Yep.
This box, there's an object. It goes from a very large circle to a very small circle.
Okay.
And if I rotate my probe 90 degrees, it seems to be tapered.
All right.
Now, if I show you what's inside this box by clicking on the layers button, you can see here's my beam.
Okay.
And the point at which it transects that cone, I get a two-dimensional image on screen. Does that make sense?
Yeah.
That's the whole concept of ultrasound.
Okay.
Now, let's show you that in the FAST protocol, because you were just saying you were seeing a whole lot of shades of gray.
Mm-hmm.
And I'll show you how that correlates to the FAST protocol.
Okay.
Here's a patient. This is an actual real case, a 24-year-old female who comes in after a motor vehicle collision. You're given her vital signs, and you're asked to perform the FAST examination. Here's my screen, right? This is my liver, and this is my kidney. But you're like, well, really understand how that is.
Great.
We'll remove the layers of anatomy here, and you can see how the beam is cutting through the liver over here and the kidney down at the bottom. If we'd like, we can actually change our position a little bit so you can see that better.
Great.
Okay, and I'll make that small over here.
That's
here's my beam.
That's
and
amazing,
because
I'm looking at both things simultaneously, and it makes a lot more sense to see it that way.
The next part of the FAST exam takes you to the bladder. So we're going to scan the bladder, and I can do the same thing over here. You see how that beam is transecting the bladder?
Yeah, okay.
And now you can, it makes it more intuitive how this two-dimensional image, which is otherwise a whole bunch of grayscale, is formed.
Okay.
Okay. Now, when you're studying with a live instructor, oftentimes they'll help you orient your probe. We can do that virtually here with either an ideal long axis or a short axis probe position if I align them. Okay, the machine is going to tell me that that's the right position. If I was holding my probe inappropriately, for example, flipped 180 degrees, a kink in the wires off, I got to reorient it.
And so, and then, let me just ask a quick question, a dumb question maybe. The black part, that's is that liquid, is that fluid, it's radiolucent?
That's
is
exactly
that,
right. Okay. We call that hypoechoic, and things that are hypoechoic are going to be blood or fluid or any other liquid, is as you termed it.
Okay.
Now, what's neat about Sonosim is the ability to click on case after case of both real and pathologic cases. So here we were talking about looking at that baby inside the gravid uterus on the rig, and here you're looking at the baby's head. Yeah. And if you wanted to do more advanced measurements, of course you can bring on calipers and do head circumference measurements. If you wanted to assess for pneumothorax, let's click on our pulmonary case. Let's say that you just picked up an 80-year-old male in respiratory distress. They're having a hard time breathing.
Yep.
What's going on with them? Why are they having such a hard time with you? Well, in this case, there's no pneumothorax. We're actually seeing lung sliding over here.
Okay.
But we can see B-line artifact, which suggests pulmonary edema. This is a guy that might benefit from some Lasix and some morphine or even a nitro on your rig.
Yeah.
So again, cases from every anatomic region of the body. Just to make something interesting over here.
Yep.
This is a patient that came in with floaters and flashing lights, loss of vision. Ultrasound of the eye shows a retinal detachment.
Right. This wouldn't be a typical pre-hospital
not
assessment.
Not an EMS assessment, but then just to show you some of the capabilities of the system.
Right. Amazing.
And then,
do you have a sample of the pneumothorax?
I do on the mannequin over here, so let's pause for 1 second. I just want to show you the newest technology we introduced.
Okay, so we're taking a walk here over to the mannequin. And
so this is Sonosim's live scan technology, and traditionally when you do simulation based training on a high fidelity mannequin, you're limited when you want to do ultrasound, because if I took a real machine and put it on this mannequin, I wouldn't get an image.
Right.
So here.
So these hotspots, if we call them that, they are, what is that, RFC technology or?
That's good. That's exactly that's right. Good. So it's near field technology. And in essence, what it is, it's registering the position of the probe. And
so
now I've put in a case, this is actually an intracardiac clot that we're seeing here on the screen.
That's amazing. So the probe is on that little sticker.
Right.
See, I know this terminology because I was just at Disney World. And,
now I'm going to convert you to a Sonosim believer. We call them live scan tags.
Live scanned tabs?
Tags, T-A-G-S, tags.
Tags.
So now I'm
going
to go over this patient's abdomen. Here, I just picked up a patient who's 70 years old, hypotensive. Yep. You put the probe on their belly and you see this big whomping abdominal aortic aneurysm.
Oh, nice. A triple A.
Big triple A.
Okay.
Or
it's
here's that fast
time
scan.
Bomb. This is time to get the out of here.
Here's that fast protocol, right? A patient that was involved in a trauma.
Right.
And what did you say that black stuff was again?
Oh, radiolucent.
What did you call it? A liquid, which
oh,
is?
Oh, liquid, yeah.
24-year-old female, motor vehicle collision. What is that?
Oh, so she's bleeding.
She's bleeding. She's bleeding to her belly.
Wow.
So you're going to radio the base physician, say, hey, I got a lady here who's hypotensive with a positive fast scan.
Yeah.
So those are just some of the EMS applications of ultrasound. And again, what we've tried to do is create a system here that facilitates ultrasound education for large groups of people. In your traditional course environment that involves having an instructor with a patient, a machine, and a student is laborious and very expensive. And this is a self-directed course, provides for a completely asynchronous and flipped classroom environment, and covers all applications of EMS care and beyond.
So, and FAST isn't just an acronym, it's FAST. It's a quick assessment.
It's quick. It should be the,
it's
the
quick
guidelines
and
say
so
less
you,
than 2 minutes.
So you know this patient's going to the closest hospital or they're going to a trauma center. You know, so if they're hemodynamically stable but they've got a bleed, trauma center might be...
I'm going to leave that to your protocol.
You're going to leave that to our protocol. Good enough.